rejoice in what happened yesterday. And by the way, I want to tell you that today, on December the 10th, we are opening a live nativity scene here at the headquarters, the West Coast headquarters of the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C., and the location of the First Southern Baptist Church on our property behind our fence, but viewable to the entire nation, viewable to anybody that walks by. We're having a live 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week Nativity and Hanukkah presentation here at our church. We are exercising our religious rights as Jews and Christians to present the Hanukkah celebration and the Nativity scene here at 6801 Western Avenue in the city of Buena Park. And if you have anything that we could use in the Nativity scene, if you have an extra Jesus or an extra Joseph or an extra Mary of a statue nature that we could put here, because you see, we can put it up 24 hours a day and even leave it, but we're going to have a combination of live and static, if you will, statues and so forth. So if you have anything that you could donate or loan us, we need a menorah, we need Mary, we need Joseph, we've got hay being delivered, but whatever you can do to help us. Number one, please pray for us, and please come down and visit us. We'd love to have you here. May God bless you, and may God give you a great, great day. All right, folks, that was leaving a message for Hunter Jameson. I'm going to try to get the other worker, 131. We'll see if we can get Joe Peterson was also one of the leaders in this committee, one of the men of action there in the Santa Monica Nativity Scenes.org. Mr. Joe Peterson, how are you this morning?
Hey, good, Wiley. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Listen, this is Wiley, and we are live on the air right now. I wanted to chat with you just for a minute on the air, if that's okay.
Sure.
Brother, we've been talking about and praising God about what your chairman, Hunter Jameson, and you, as sort of second in charge, Joe Peterson, and what you folks have done with what the devil meant for evil, God turned to good. And, of course, we have on video and everywhere all over the world on Channel 2, Channel 7, Channel 9, the beautiful nativity scene that was erected on Saturday. And then we also have around the world what happened yesterday. And, ladies and gentlemen, you saw Mr. Joe Peterson and you saw Mr. Hunter Jameson and the rest of the folks, the choirs, the red and yellow, black and white, all God's people there at the great, great dedication. Now, Joe, if people would like to come as we did yesterday and see those nativity scenes that the city kicked off of the beach, where do they go and how do they get there?
Well, if you're in parts of Los Angeles or coming from any distance, it would be west of the 405 and south of the 10 freeway. And Ocean Park runs east and west. So it's on Ocean Park Boulevard in the 2700 block. So the easy thing to do there would be to find parking in that vicinity. There is a public park right next door, but we don't want to overwhelm them. Then you can leisurely get out and walk the 2700 block. The actual address for the building itself that they're in front of is 2716 Ocean Park Boulevard.
Now, I did not get in my notes the name of the company that very graciously allowed you to put those nativity scenes there. What's the name of that company?
The Watt Companies.
W-A-T-T?
Yeah.
W-A-T-T Company, and they're a construction, engineering, that kind of thing.
They're a real estate development company. They've built many homes over the years, post-World War II, shopping centers.
Okay, so they're a real estate development organization. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have need for that kind of business, I would encourage you just to go and check out Watt Company, W-A-T-T, and they are located there at 2716 Ocean Park Boulevard, and that's where you can drive by and see these beautiful, gorgeous items that had left on the beach there every year for 59 years, and now this year they've been booted out, and of course the Watt Company allowed them to be placed there. Not only that, they even put lights on them and did a great job, and we thank the Lord for the Watt Company, and we also thank the Lord for the committee. Now, Joe, give our listening audience, if you will, the website for the committee if folks would like more information or if they would like to be a part by making a donation for the expenses of having to move these things.
Sure. And at the website, you can also see photographs of what they look like today, and I think there's even some historical pictures there, too, from past celebrations that they've had. The web address is www.santamonicanativityscenes.org, and there's a little place you can sign up to be on a newsletter. We will be taking this on appeal, the decision that was made that dismissed this at the federal level. We are going to be appealing that, so you might, your listeners might want to be updated as we do that. And, of course, like you said, there is a PayPal button there for donations. Our annual expenses are nearly $20,000. And as you might imagine, and if you look closely, when people visit the scenes, they will see that there's some fairly old parts for some of these displays and the booths and the components, and we do need to update them from time to time. So anything that anyone might want to do would be very much appreciated.
Well, we certainly want to encourage our listeners live on television and radio. Ladies and gentlemen, go to that website, santamonicanativityscenes.org. Help them, pray with them. And go by there if you're anywhere near Santa Monica. Many of you go to the 3rd Street Promenade. It's not very far from there. You could go by the promenade and have lunch and then drive up a little ways there to the 2716 block of Ocean Park and be able to see those beautiful scenes. And go to the website, of course, and check it out and go there and make a donation to them.
They also suggest, we do this to tell the Christmas story to people who don't know it. So pray for the people of Santa Monica. There's a lot of spiritual strongholds in Santa Monica, and we need revival there.
Amen. We certainly do, and we certainly will continue to pray for Santa Monica. We understood yesterday, not only did we see on the news what you folks did yesterday for your dedication, but for the day before, when the live nativity scene was there with your committee, as well as with Survivors.LA, that's their website. They came, they staffed the live nativity scene with a live baby Jesus and Mary and Joseph and wise men and shepherds and so forth, and angels and all kind of live scenery. And then from there, the live nativity moved down to the 3rd Street Promenade and sang Christmas carols, and then came back to the area and sang Christmas carols. And we understand that there were other groups coming in at 7 o'clock to sing carols along the promenade, along the beach there at Palisades, rather. And also we heard on the news that other churches were saying, hey, if those groups, if the committee can go and survivors can go, we as a church can go. And so churches are taking their choirs there. And that nativity scene is being remanned from time to time by different churches. Do you know any of the names of the churches that are doing
it? I don't know, but I believe Hunter mentioned yesterday in the dedication that it will be a fairly frequent schedule that they'll be having from now. It could even be every evening. I'm not sure exactly. But I believe they're going to be meeting down near the, I believe it's Colorado, the most southern tip of the park, the Palisades Park.
Right. And my understanding is, starting last night and even before, at around 7 o'clock, people are there. One of the ladies on television said, we've got hot cocoa, we've got donuts, we've got Hanukkah food, and so forth. And so this is indeed a multi-religious celebration, the celebration of Christmas, the nativity scene, and Hanukkah, the scene and the blessings that Israel received. And, of course, we as Christians are Jews because that's what the Bible says about us. And so what a great opportunity. Every evening at around 7 o'clock, those activities are going on the south end, if you will, there of Palisades Park, as well as the nativity scene will be being manned from time to time. And so we thank the Lord for what you all are doing. And we ask, we covet your prayers as well. The Lord laid on my heart this morning when I heard about what was going on with other groups manning the live nativity and manning the carol singing. It was brought to my attention by the Lord that we should do that. So today, on December the 5th, we're opening a live nativity scene about 35 miles from Santa Monica, just up the street from Knott's Berry Farm. And we're going to have a live nativity scene 24 hours a day, around the clock, through the month of December. And that's going to become an annual thing for us. And you guys motivated that, and you guys inspired that. And we want you and others to pray for us. Now, I do need to...
Well, we will do that. Praise the Lord.
And I do need to mention to you, though, and other listeners, that we're a small church. We had a big crowd last night in church. We had about 75 people. But normally, we have about 40 to 50. But we're a small church. I just had someone donate 8 bales of hay for our nativity scene. So we got the beginning. We're going to have a little creche with a baby Jesus in it. Right now, it's going to be a doll unless somebody wants to bring their child. And but we're going to have a nativity scene. And anyone who has anything that they would like to help us with, like a statue of Joseph or Mary or anything that would fit into a nativity Hanukkah scene. I need a big menorah. I don't have one. And I need one. If someone has a menorah, they'd like to loan us for the month to honor Hanukkah. If someone has part of a scene they'd like to loan us or give us, we'll promise you we'll take good care of it. It'll have 24-hour security, and we'll take good care of it. But anything anyone could donate for our nativity scene for the rest of this month, we'd appreciate it. We'll be glad to pick it up. We'll come get it. We'll bring it back at the end of the month. But we need your help. And if anybody would like to call, you can reach me at 714-865-8132. 714-865-8132. We do need a menorah so we can properly represent Hanukkah, and we need some other things as well. Now, Joe Peterson, ladies and gentlemen, with the committee, and that committee's website is SantaMonicaNativityScenes.org. Now, did I get that right?
Yes, you did.
Okay. And any other information, prayer requests, praise reports you'd like to give our worldwide audience?
Well, just pray for revival. And, you know, every city, every town, every village in the United States needs it. And we're selfish and want to start in Santa Monica, but we'll be happy if it starts everywhere.
Well, we certainly do agree with you. I have the privilege to pastor here now for 25 years in Buena Park. And obviously, I'm very selfish in that sense. I don't mean that negatively, but very selfish that this happened here in Buena Park. But I also will be very happy when it happens in Santa Monica or when it happens. I saw a press release this morning that Los Angeles revival hits Azusa Street. And I would encourage anyone, if you're interested in that, go to ChristianNewsWire.com. ChristianNewsWire.com. They have put out a press release. I cannot speak for it, against it, or anything other than to say that on Sunday, December the 9th, they put out a press release at ChristianNewsWire.com that says there's a revival hitting Azusa Street. And, of course, most of you know that many, many years ago, the great Azusa Street revival began there on Azusa Street. Maybe, just maybe, God's going to allow that to happen again. And I do know the chaplain and the dear lady that's involved in that, but go to ChristianNewsWire.com, and on yesterday's press releases, Los Angeles revival hits Azusa Street. And I'm trusting and hoping in the very near future that we here on the Wiley Drake Show can say revival hits Santa Monica as a result of what the devil did to attack God's people.
Amen. You know, I did want to just mention one more thing.
And sure.
A few years back, we were upgrading the scenes. And, you know, they are mannequins and, you know, different sort of scenes of the Nativity, you know, and Mary and Joseph went to Egypt, or the Annunciation of Gabriel and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
And we thought, well, we're not really telling the story very well because the scripture is not part of the scenes. So Carrie Caesar in our church decided she was going to have banners made. And these banners are about 3 feet wide and about 5 or 6 feet tall. And she's kind of a calligrapher, but she had them blown up and, you know, laminated and hung them in each of the 14 booths. Well, things were sleepy and wonderful until that happened, and that is when the atheist came out. As soon as God's word is put on display, it's like itching powder to them or something. But, you know.
Well, you're absolutely right. And my dear brother, in the very middle of our nativity scene here, in addition to all the nativity scenes, are the big granite Ten Commandments monument, as well as directly behind that monument in the scene is a giant, about a 12-foot high, what we call the Barbara Drake Memorial Prayer Cross. And this is where people can walk by and put in their prayer requests, because we have a little box on the cross. And so when they see our nativity scene, they're going to see not only the Ten Commandments, but they're going to see this Barbara Drake Memorial Cross. Barbara was my wife, passed away a couple of years ago.
I'm sorry to hear that.
We dedicated that cross to her ministry. Her ministry goes on because we're in a large Roman Catholic area. We're right around the corner from St. Pius V Catholic Church. Many of those Catholics will not come in our church, but many of those Catholics will walk by, look at the nativity scene, and put their prayer request in our prayer request box on the memorial cross. And so we'll see what happens here. We're going to continue to preach the gospel and share Jesus with folks. And so we thank the Lord for what you guys are doing. We'd love to have you visit Buena Park. Let me know. I'm in and out a lot, but we'd love to have you come and say a prayer of dedication from your committee over our nativity scene. And we'd love to have you visit us at any time. Our pulpit is open to you. Our studio is open, and certainly the live 24-hour day nativity scene is open to you anytime. Tell any groups that want to come. If any of those folks that sang yesterday would love to come down here anytime, 24 hours a day, all I got to do is let us know. We'll be glad to let them come and sing and be a part of this live nativity scene.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, my dear brother. God bless you. Have
Thank
a great,
you.
Great day. Ladies and gentlemen, Joe Peterson with the Santa Monica Nativity Scenes.org. Go and check it out. Go over and visit them at 2716 Ocean Park Boulevard. Share in their rejoicing in the Lord. And most of all, pray for a revival. I believe that with all my heart That's why we're doing what we're doing, and I know that's why they're doing what they're doing. May God bless you, Joe. Have a great day.
Amen. Bless you, too.
God bless you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we only have about 10 minutes left, 11 minutes, something like that. If you would like to call us, call in on the number that Joe was on, 1-800-839-3002. Give us a call. We'd be more than happy to hear from you. All right. We're going to see if we can get in touch with Fred Berry. Good morning. God bless you, and welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. You're live on the air.
Yes, this is Wes Parker from Bellflower.
Wes Parker from Bellflower. God bless you, my brother. Listen, I'm glad you called. We're opening up today here at the First Southern Baptist Church a live nativity scene right out front. You know where our cross is there. And if you know of anyone who has a mannequin, a statue of Mary or Joseph or a wise man or a shepherd or anything that could help us with that scene, we appreciate you passing the word. Now, Wes Parker, you have a scene up at your home. Is that right?
Well, I have some giant snowman. It's one of them is a snowman Marine honoring our American veterans and our Marines, and another is a police department honoring our, you know, police force, and another is for our firemen. And these are our, you know, I'm honoring our public servants, these people that put their lives on the line for us to serve us. So it's just to honor them. My father, he was actually a volunteer policeman and fireman. So I did this to honor him and also put up one for the Marines. And I was just going to let you know, I sent you an email there, and it gives my address. So at some time when you were saying you want to come do a show, I'll contact you after the show here on your cell phone, and you can kind of look at your schedule, and any day, you know, starting tomorrow will be good. So,
well, brother, we'll certainly do that, and I'll get back in touch with you. Give me a call somewhere after 10 o'clock today, 10 or 11. The other thing is, I was wondering if you have anything that you might like to loan us, one of those three characters to put in our nativity scene. I don't know how big they are or how hard they'd be to transport or anything, but anything that you would have that you could donate to our scene would be greatly appreciated.
Okay, I'll take a look and see what I got. We had a large nativity scene here that we used to display, but I'm not really sure what happened to it.
Well, let me tell you what we're doing. Right out front, we're right in the very infant stages of this, and I need your help and everybody's help. Basically, the Lord gave me the idea this morning. We're going to put up a nativity scene that includes the Ten Commandments and the cross. And aside to that, I just ordered 8 bales of hay to be put out there to give it the nativity scene look. And then we're going to put a creche there with the Christ child, and we're going to have people manning it 24 hours a day. If you know any church choir or any group of singers that would like to come and perform, they're welcome to do so. It's open air. It's outside. It's right on Western Avenue. If you have anything that you would like to put in our nativity scene, we promise you we'll guard it. And we promise you, you'll get it back. And that's to not only Brother West, but anybody. And it'd be great for you if you have something that you could add to our scene. We would appreciate it greatly.
Okay, well, I'll take a look and see what I got. Find anything extra. But I'll let you get going to the other phone call now that I hear.
Okay, brother. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye.
All right, welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. You're live on the air, on television, and on radio. If you'd not like to be on television and radio, you can just hang up and call back after 10 o'clock. I guess they didn't want to be on, so they hung up. All right. Well, that's okay. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to be a part of the Wiley Drake Show, if you'd like to bring something, here's what we need. We need a Mary and a Joseph statue. We need a menorah. Some of you Jewish folks out there, give us a call, give us a holler, let us know what's going on. I'm going to call and see if I can get in touch with a local pastor here. See if we can get Jonathan Vincent, pastor of an old, old church. He's not that old, but the church is over 100 years old.
First Congregational Church, may I help you?
You certainly can. This is Pastor Wiley Drake down at First Southern Baptist Church. Is Jonathan in?
No, he doesn't come in until sometime late in the afternoon on Mondays.
Okay.
I have your message, and I'll have him call you when he gets in, but it was not one of those things that I could address for you other than...
Oh, I understand. I understand. I just need him. I'd like for him to call in and be on with us or share with us, and would love to have, if you guys have a choir... basically, I don't remember how much information I gave you, but we're setting up today a live nativity scene 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have a choir or a singing group that would like to come, all they got to do is just come. They don't even have to let us know. I mean, it'd be fine if they did. We don't want to double book, but if somebody, if they would like to come, we'd love to have them. Just give them my phone number and tell them to call me.
Right. We are actually doing our own nativity, so we don't have either singers or equipment to spare for you.
Okay, that's fine. We're just offering it to the community. Anyone that would like to participate, they're welcome to do so.
Right.
Do you happen to know who the local rabbi is?
Hang on a second, you know, because that was why I was going to have him call you, because I don't know for sure, but let me look and see if I have something.
Okay, I appreciate that. Ladies and gentlemen, what we're trying to do is find out who the local rabbi is, so I want to try to get a menorah from them if we can. And
yeah, but, you know, I don't have their number. His name is Rabbi Mark Goldfarb.
Mark Goldfarb?
Yeah, G-O-L-D-F-A-R-B.
Okay.
And he's at Temple Beth Or, O-H-R, but I don't have a phone number for him.
And it's O-H-R. Is that in La Mirada, or do you know?
Think that's in Buena Park.
Oh, okay. So it's Temple Beth Orr in Buena Park, Mark Goldfarb.
I believe so, yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we were trying to work through a local church. And can you find Marco Goldfarb and see if you can get in touch with him and tell him I need a menorah and need a rabbi? Ladies and gentlemen, we've only got about 5 minutes before we go off the air. And we thank you so much for listening today. I want to remind you, at 4 o'clock today, you will see more of the video from Santa Monica. You'll see more pictures from the scenes. You'll see more pictures from what's going on. And if you can help us in any way, if you can help us in any way with our live nativity scene, today, on December the 10th, in the year of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, 2012, we're going to dedicate this day, and we're going to start a fire, and that fire will be eternally kept going to honor our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and to honor the holiday of Hanukkah that honors God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost as the oil was provided, as the time was provided there 2,100 years ago when the Brotherhood organization, the Muslim Brotherhood, and the Syrians were trying to make the Jews give up their religion, and they desecrated the temple. And when they desecrated the temple, they destroyed all the blessed oil. But when they came back, they beat those guys. They won the battle. They went in to rededicate the temple. They had no dedicated oil yet, and they found one small cruse of oil that had not been contaminated. It had the seal of the high priest on it. It was sealed and dedicated and had not been contaminated by the pagans. And so they put that little oil into use, and what was to be less than a day's oil usage lasted for more than 8 days. giving them an opportunity to get back in the temple, rededicate oil, and continue their religious worship of Almighty God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost as they worship. We only have about 2 minutes left, folks. If you'd like to call, you better hurry. Remember, at 4 o'clock, the pre-show, the opening act with Jaime Chan and all of the videos from all over the country, videos from literally all over the world that will be on from 4 to 5. And then at 5 o'clock, Wiley Drake live at 5. And we thank you for being a part of this show today, and we encourage you to be a part of the show tonight. Now, we thank the Lord and praise God for what you're doing and what the Lord is doing. We're coming up now on just about 1 minute before we go off the air, and we are going to close with our theme, what we start with and what we finish with each day. And we now have 1 minute left. In this last minute, let me say to you, the Bible says, without Jesus Christ, you die and go to hell. The Bible also says you can become a Christian by inviting Jesus Christ into your heart and into your life. You do it like this. You simply say, I know that Jesus is God. I know that I can't do enough to get to heaven on my own. And I ask Jesus to come into my heart and into my life and make me his child. And if you do that, folks, then you too can adopt the theme for the Wiley Drake Show. And that theme is, do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. Feliz Navidad, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, and may God bless you and give you a great, great day.
Mind, I won't say my stand in the battle.